Well, welcome everyone to the second Ring Around Vietnam. This is our series looking at what's happening with the lockdown and making across the wider world. And it's great to focus on Vietnam because we've had a lot of interesting stories from Vietnam, and it's certainly a dynamic part of the world. And it happens to be one of the first countries coming out of lockdown. So we can see from the way in which they're emerging, perhaps something of our own future. And so we have a lot to learn from this dynamic country. And we're very grateful to have one of the key people behind the Vietnamese scene, Mr. Le Ba Ngoc, with us. Good evening, Mr. Ngoc.
Yeah, good evening, Kevin.
Yes. Where are you at the moment?
I'm in my office now in Hanoi, capital of Vietnam. Actually, right. We were away from the office for almost 3 weeks, but now we are back to the office for only a few days.
I see. So what was it like traveling around Vietnam over the last few weeks?
Last few weeks, all of us were at home. But you know, the lockdown has been applied in the countries. Then nobody allowed to be, to travel. Even in Vietcraft, you know, we travel a lot, but for last 3 weeks, then this is the first time in our life we have to be, we have to stay at home. Then it's a very strange situation, but luckily we got familiar with that situation. And now, you know, the life been lived in Vietnam, of part in we still have two areas in Vietnam, Smoker Mill, that the government of Vietnam applied the lockdown, because in, I think in that area there's been one or two cases of COVID, then the whole area have been in the lockdown. But to see in that area, normally we have to get permissions. If you are in the lockdown areas, you have to get permission to travel. And it's not easy, even you have the permissions. But when you travel to other commune or other province, you will be checked by many, many layers of inspectors. Then actually it's very, very inconvenient to travel. Then to avoid that situation, then the better stay at home.
Yes. Well, Mr. Ngoc, you're famous for your energy, and I've heard of many epic journeys that you've had through Vietnam, sleeping in the back of cars, tirelessly cataloging the crafts, which I think was a bit of the origin of Vietcraft. Is that right? Can you explain a bit about Vietcraft to begin with?
Yeah. Vietcraft stands for Vietnam Handicraft Exporters Associations, and we are the function of Vietcraft is to promote a handicraft sector in Vietnam, mainly for export markets. Of course, we work with both local and international markets, but mainly our activity is for export markets. Vietcraft had been established since 2007. And we have 800 member companies. Our member are mainly handicraft exporters in Vietnam. As you know, handicraft sector is quite very strong in Vietnam. And every year we exported more or less $2.2 billion, mainly for USA market, United States market, and European countries, Japan, and even Australia, that we're exporting a lot of handicraft items. When you talk about handicrafts in Vietnam, it means that you talk about the popular items like ceramic, natural fibers, lacquerware, wood carving. You have also many different types of textile in Vietnam. It can be, let's say, the hand looms, or it can be the motor looms, but we have a lot of textile in Vietnam also. And you know, the Vietnam had a long tradition of producing handicrafts, and the whole country, we have over 2,000 craft villages. And that's why Vietgrab is trying to promote the product from different craft villages in Vietnam to the world. And we have many different activities. We offer the, let's say, we build capacity for our handcraft exporters. We provide information, the market information. We offer a lot of consultancy services to member company in different different type services. I mean, it can be the market trends, the design trends, or some finishing of some products. And we organize a lot of trade promotional activities, either in Vietnam or in other countries. But with Grab, so we work with a lot of international partners and try to build the image of Vietnam handcraft to our international buyers. And with Grab, so the owner or initiator of some events, special events in Vietnam. I mean, it can be some festivals. We organize international lighting festival in Vietnam. We organize the Lifestyle Vietnam International Home Decor and Gift Show that
yes, every well, year. While we're talking about Lifestyle Vietnam, perhaps you can also introduce the One Village, One Product, which Vietnam now is, I believe, a global leader in promoting. Can you explain about how that came about and what the strategy is for Vietnam?
Yeah, actually, after many years of operations, we found the huge potential for international corporations to develop One Village, One Product. As you may know, that One Village, One Product have been initiated in Japan since 1979. In 1990s, Vietgrab was the strategic partner of the One Village, One Product Japan. And we work closely with many OVOP, we call movements in other countries. Then we found that by working together, maybe we can bring some value to our partner countries, and we can bring some value to our Vietnamese producer also. And that's why in 2018, Vietgrab together with One Village, One Product Japan in Oita, we decided to establish an international network on OVOP. After OVOP Japan in 1979, up to now, we have more or less 43 countries. Then they're working with One Village, One Product program at many different levels. Some countries have very early program like Taiwan, China, or let's say Thailand in 1981, they started OVOP. But some other countries, even they started last year, like Argentina, and started already last year. Then because we travel around, we collect the needs from many different countries. And we found that most of the countries, they show their interest in working to develop OVOP in their country. Then last year, together with Vietnamese, we were supported by Vietnamese government. And last year, Vietnamese government held a meeting, and Kevin Chu Joy, and we decided to launch the international network of One Village, One Product, we call IOVOP. Then after setting up the network, actually it will be very easy it operated by Vietgrab, but because our government, they want to IOVOP at the governmental levels. Then now they have big discussions between ASEAN countries now. But you know that this year Vietnam is the chairman of the ASEAN network. Then we brought the issue, we bring the issue of IOVOP to the ASEAN member countries. Then we are making a big discussion now how to bring the benefit for every country at the third in ASEAN countries. But at the same time, the Vietnamese government also, they are going to travel to Latin America and to find a way to work together with that area. Of course, we have some initial agreement between the countries how we will work together. But now, now is the time we make very specific schedule plans for every countries to make sure that every country, the member country, will be benefited from the networks. Then the expectation from government of Vietnam is a little bit ambitious, but they want to bring the governmental levels to be in the network, not only business level, not only association levels like Vietcraft, but as a governmental levels. That's why they want to bring the minister of some ministries and to bring even the leader of the countries to be in the network. Then still in the discussion, or I can say in the lobbying or discussion period.
Yes, well, I think it's very interesting for us to see how Vietnam is taking the lead in this international network, particularly when we're looking at a future, at least in the short term, which involves de-globalization, with greater focus on local manufacture. And One Village, One Product is one of these glocalized networks which encourages local specialization, but is an international network built partly on solidarity, but potential partnerships in terms of exchange. And it's potentially something which the world might look to in terms of a future path out of lockdown without going back to the more centralized versions of globalization where, say, all of the widgets came out of China and there were very few local productions, but there were kind of main factory nations that were providing the world, but a much more distributed area, particularly in terms of craft and agriculture. And we're very pleased, too, to have in our upcoming Africa issue, Joseph Ndoni, who is the Senegalese representative in the One Village, One Product network. So it's sort of growing as a particular kind of network. Now, I wanted to get your opinion on the issue of export, because while we're coming out of lockdown in the future, one of the issues is going to be about the export markets and whether they're still as open as they were, partly due to demand and other issues to do with transport, and also tourism, of course, which will be much reduced in the short term. How do you see Vietnam responding to these challenges to do with lockdown and coronavirus?
As you know, that Vietnam takes very strong action with the virus, and we cannot say that we were successful with the prevention of the virus. But the government of Vietnam seems to pay them very much attention now. But we said maybe there will be the virus will be back, and nobody will know what will happen in the coming days. And that's why we still lockdown for international travel now. And because of the virus, the handcraft, the craft sector have been affected a lot. But as you know, that as I mentioned earlier, that our product mainly for export markets. But for last few months, most of the customer they cancel the orders, and some customers said they have to delay the delivery. They because you know every shop, every supermarket also closed in other countries. You know, Spain, for instance, or Italy, America, a very big market for Vietnam. We know already what happened over there. And order, every day we receive the information for our members that order have been canceled or have been delayed, or even the payment, so payment have been delayed for a few months. That actually it's very difficult situations. Then the government, they have the, I think the, they have a subsidy for the company. The company can get loan from the bank without interest, or even some small production group can get some subsidy, even in cash. Then that will what the government can do for the companies. Of course, for some other kind of tax, the tax will be only 50%. Apply even some company you don't have to pay for the taxes. Then what will happen in the coming days is still not clear, because we see that it's very complicated with the international situation now. Some countries like we don't know what happened in United States, that they step by step they leave the lockdown, but many people die every day now, and the problem is not only because of travel, even for the online activity, because the lockdown in other countries, then the craft sector in Vietnam have been already, I think, sleeping for time being. Nobody can take any actions once we depend a lot on the international markets. And some companies, they try to replace international market with the local markets, but still it takes very slow action for time being. And for the international travel, of course, now since no international travel allowed in Vietnam, and we don't see much. We cannot forget what will happen. Actually, we cannot forget what happened in the next month or like 2 months. Even for Vietnam, as you know, we have to delay from April to October. But now we are still not sure if we can organize in October or not. Of course, it will be similar to other countries, you know, international fair like Maison Objet in Paris. And so they said they're not sure if they're going to organize in September. I think the situation is, at least with the craft sector, I have to say it was terrible for time being. Many companies, they cannot pay for the worker. Even the worker have to don't get any salary, any payment for the last 2 or 3 months, and that was a very big challenge. Then hopefully, at least in the next 2 months, we will not expect too much for the international market or even for the international travels, and you know what would happen after this.
Yes, thank you for sharing that very sober analysis of the situation in Vietnam. I think we're all holding on and hoping we can last through the lockdown, but it's also a time for trying out new kinds of possibilities, new ways of connecting, and so we hope to be sharing that with the General Garland Network and looking at what's happening in Vietnam, so that when we come out, we can be enjoying again the variety and the beauty and the meanings of Vietnamese craft, because it seemed in a way that Vietnam was just on the cusp, on the beginning of showing itself to be revealing its richness. I'm thinking also of Hanoi as a creative city for design, and the plans for the upcoming festival that would draw on the thousands of craft villages in the province. Do you see that as something which will be happening in the future?
We were planning for the craft festival in Vietnam in coming November, and the government of Vietnam agreed for that plans. But the problem is, because we organize international event, then it needs time for our partner to prepare for the event. Even now, last few days we have a meeting to talk about that event. Then the government of Vietnam still insists that if the situation improves, I mean that if the lockdown lifts, then the event will be organized in coming November. But it seems that it will be difficult, because if you give the partner maybe 2 or 3 months to prepare in advance, that will be not enough.
Right. Then, well, Mr. Ngoc, if I can say on behalf of all of the Garland readers, we admire so much the work you've put in to creating Vietcraft, what you've done for Vietnam, but now for the world with being a champion of One Village, One Product. And I'm sure we will all continue to support what you do through all the various networks, the World Crafts Council, Garland Magazine, and so on. I think you've built a lot of trust and support, and we wish you very well in the future. Do you have any final message that you would like to offer before we depart?
Thank you, Kevin. Actually, for sure, we need a lot of your support. But when we look at your, let's say, as a talent, we know that you travel a lot and you have a very, very big network. I think by working closely together between IOVP of the graduate talent, we can share a story with our friends in many different countries. And especially in these situations, then if we can do partnership and we can share our experience, we can learn from each other, that will be perfect. Then I hope that we hope that Garland's magazine and Vietnam can work more closely together and to promote the crab on the cooperation between the crab people in different countries. Mm-hmm. And thank you, Kevin. I think that would be, we need also very much of the support. I read the Garland very often. Then one food magazine. Learn a lot.
come on, Mr. Nock. And this is really the start of the journey. And we have so much ahead of us. And we just need to hold on through this challenge. So thank you so much. And
thank you, Kevin. Thank you so much. Goodbye.